Lower freight costs have a positive impact on production and trade within the region. It's on this backdrop that the Ugandan business community has been appealing to the Tanzanian government to reduce the road user fees from $16.
They have reduced barriers. The issue we have now with Central Corridor is to see the issue of the road toll. Because the road toll has been there for 10 years, you see the standard of the ESC, I think, is $60 per 100 kilometer. Then, when our truck comes in Tanzania, we have to pay more than $520 road toll. And when they come, they pay $6 per 100 kilometer.
This demand caught the attention of President Samia Suluhu Hassan during her recent state visit to Uganda. President Samia Suluhu of the United Republic of Tanzania acknowledged the importance of the private sector in steering social and economic development and reined on the matter by announcing a $6 reduction.
General, I should say we have heard you. We have heard your concerns. We have heard your complaints. And take it from me, we're going to work on them.
The incentive has been lauded by the government of Uganda officials, private sector players, and the Central Corridor Secretariat.
So I think now the business community should take this opportunity and to keep high the momentum.
As of now, we are waiting for the implementation to be done. You see, the issue of road user fee, it is not only the problem. There is the issue of allowing clearing agents to work freely in Dar es Salaam port, to work in Tanzania. There were some issue of getting work permit. Ugandans getting a work permit. There is an issue of communication system. For those who are traveling in Dar es Salaam, Tanzania, you know how expensive it is to call back in Kampala. So there is a need of harmonization of the of the communication system.
Landlocked countries like Uganda face greater challenges than other countries, not only in terms of higher cost of freight services, but also due to a high degree of unpredictability in the transportation time. The situation is worsened by other problems, such as the security of cargo in transit, as well as scarcity and high costs of third-party inventory and distribution services.
You're talking about the $10 from $16. I would like to understand that the reduction in a common man's language, in a layman's context, how does it work? And how does it benefit a business person and maybe someone also who owns a truck or someone who uses the route?
For issue of the $10, one, it reduces the cost on transport. You see, once the transport reduces the cost, $10 not... when you enter into Tanzania, when like you are going to Bukoba, which means you will pay 100 kilometer, $10. You don't pay a full amount.
Who pays that?
A transporter or a driver. So really, which is a bit bringing down the cost. You see, transport cost in the region is the highest in the world. Reason being of non-tariff barriers, such as road user fee, are not harmonized. You can see Congo. When you go to DRC, you enter 2 kilometers, you pay $250. In fact, even DRC needed to harmonize since they have entered the East African community.
Dennis Igoa for UBC Business.